Thank you. Hello, how are you guys? My name is Mateusz. I am the community manager for Anshar Studios, and today with me is Marcin.
Hello.
I have to adjust your camera because it goes. Oh yeah, it should be fine now. Okay, so we are ready to go. How are you guys today? How are you, Marcin?
Oh, am I? Well, the air pressure is too low today in Poland, so my blood pressure is not too high, and I'm a little bit sleepy, but I hope I will wake up seeing this demo. Hopefully. So,
Okay, I have a
yeah.
confession to make. I haven't played the demo. No,
That's a
not at
surprise.
all. Not at all. Not 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 a single second.
I thought that everybody in Anshar Studios played the demo,
No, I did it on
but
purpose. So
you didn't.
it won't be unbiased. So it will be unbiased. It won't be
Yes,
biased. Yeah.
I will have to explain to you everything because this demo is just part of the game that is in the middle of the game. It doesn't explain a lot. You will be cast onto the deep water, indeed. So beware, you have been warned.
Okay, so let's see if I did everything correctly. I'm wondering why you guys don't hear the audio.
I can hear it. I can hear this music.
Yeah, I know you can, but I don't think. Okay, can you hear the music in the background?
I can hear the music from the menu of the game.
Yeah, you can hear it because I have a separate stream for you,
Yeah.
just for you can. Okay, so
I
it's
can.
all good. So let's start the game. Like I said, I haven't played this demo. This is the backers build. Let's call it number two. So we will be playing on the low city.
Oh, yes. Oh, you skipped it. There was something written over there. I wanted to read it, but you skipped it. Okay. I don't like you. Okay.
Who
So here
has
we
time for
are.
reading?
Here we are in the lowest part of Warsaw City. This part is called ROU, Roof of the Under City. It's really very low, but you are already in the middle of conversation. Okay.
Okay, so little technical issues, but we're back on track. Who are we? Who is Game Deck, Marcin? In one sentence, who is Game Deck?
Why one sentence?
Because I
Why?
know you like to talk a lot.
Oh, you are from PR, from marketing, and marketing guys like everything in one sentence. Okay, so in one sentence, Game Deck is a game detective, which means that he or she solves crimes. That involve sensory worlds, that is virtual realities of the future. This game is set at the end of the 22nd century, and it occurs that game decks are needed. Sometimes you just have to be a good player, a good detective. You have to know people and know how to dwell in virtual realities to solve some problems.
Okay, so this is the second backers build, the second demo
Yes.
for backers from Kickstarter.
Yeah.
There is a portion of this demo available for everyone on Steam or GOG. So if you want to play this game, just go and download it. It's for free. So we have some changes from the last build. We got a lot of feedback from you guys, and we really sat down and talk about it. So we have not notification if you have something new in the codex or in professions, and from time to time you can see some alerts on the screen telling you that you have some new objectives or that you unlock something in the codex, etc. So I have another question for you. I will be asking many questions today.
Yeah, okay. I'm
So,
ready.
where are we? What is Low City? I know that you don't like to call it slums. you like to call it something else. Yeah, why it's not slums? Because people think that Game Deck is all about cyberpunk, and all cyberpunk games have to have slums.
No. It's
how
not
is
like
Game
that.
Deck different from
yes,
any
Game
other
Deck,
game?
When I was writing about Game Deck, the first stories, I didn't know that I was writing cyberpunk. It was just I just loved games, so I just wanted to create stories and then novels about game detective to show the games of the future, to show how games will evolve, and so. It wasn't my intention just to create the world of cyberpunk. My creation was to create a world around the main hero, the world evolving, the world of the future, for sure, but not necessarily a cyberpunk world. So there are no slums here. This is just the lowest part of the polis, of the city, of Gargantuan City, which is Warsaw City. So people live here. The normal people, they don't earn too much. Because if you earn more, then you can move higher to the higher parts of the city where you can see the sunshine. Here we cannot see the sunshine. If you will move a little bit to the south, to the southern part of the pavement, you will see maybe a little bit of the ruins of Undercity. Well, every polis in every big city in Game Deckverse is built on ruins of the old town. Here, Warsaw City is built on ruins of old Warsaw. These are very, very big towers that are built on the ruins of Warsaw, and every megapolis is built like that. So we are on the lowest pavement. Oh, Jesus.
It wasn't me.
Well done.
Nothing to see here. Move along. Move along.
What you did was tinkering with the trophy box of Outrangers. Shouldn't have done that, really.
I really love the lighting on here. Yeah,
I wasn't paying attention to what you were doing. So, going back to the topic, yes, you can see the ruins are over there. And yes, as I have said, it is the lowest part of the city. And why is it dark here? It is not because it is the night. No, it is the middle of the day. But the net of the pavements above is so thick that it appears to be night. And it is not raining over there. The rain is only in the lower parts of the
so
of
there
the
is no sunshine
city.
In here.
Yes, and this rain is just a dirty rain. It's because of the... I don't know how to call it in English. Well, the water vaporizes. It turns from vapor to droplets and falls down. Okay, what are you doing, Matthew?
So, who is she? She looks very interesting.
So, she's an actress.
Yeah, we can just jump to the lore of Game Deck and you can talk something more about people who decide to live a kind of different life than
yes,
we do today.
Model Mac is an actress. She uses Mobrium. Mobrium is this mechanical body. She had an accident some time ago, and now the only human part that remained is her brain. Her brain is inside this mechanical body. And this is how she makes money. She's just a famous actress that uses mechanical body. That's who she is.
Yeah, she felt kind of embarrassed that I didn't know who she was. So.
Well, she is here with the director, movie director, and she is going to recreate in the movie the history of one of the Outrangers. This Outranger character's name is Tancred Brut. She is on the left side. She was very brave. She saved lives of other Outrangers, and now she is in Mobrium too, but she is in some sort of combat Mobrium. Oh, here, there she is. There she stands.
It's a Mobrium as well.
Yes.
So there are different kinds of Mobriums.
Yes. The actress was... before you do anything, please consider what you are doing. The actress uses the civilian Mobrium, and this Tancred Brute, Sergeant Brute, uses the Outrangers Mobrium, which is a protective shell to protect her when she dwells outside of anti-bios barrier.
I like this avatar. It looks kind of cool.
Yeah.
And the parrot is just outstanding, really.
Yes, this parrot is part of her therapeutic program. She has PTSD, post-traumatic stress syndrome, and this parrot is switched on when the stress is too big for her. So she, her mind is in Virtualium, where she undergoes a therapy, and this parrot is just part of her psyche that protects her.
Okay, so we have to live.
I think you have done something wrong to...
I did something wrong already. I'm just 5 minutes into the game.
You did two bad things. First, you tinkered with the trophy box, then you...
This is who I am. I am very well known for breaking games, so I should be working in the QA.
Do you read the lines? Do you read the texts?
Yes, I do. Yes,
really?
I do.
Mm. Okay.
I'm just... Wanna look something? Oh, yeah. Bomber Tancred with information. Yeah, why not? Use positive set.
Okay. Okay, do it again.
Can I do it?
Yes, you can. You can. I'm wondering what the result will be.
Yeah, but does it count that I do it all the time?
Yes, it does. Let's go to her and see the effects.
How many times did you play this demo?
I don't know. I have written it. So.
Oh
my god! You have all the results.
Yeah,
so
she's probably overthinking right now. How many positive
reinforcements? Can you see the cat? It's no longer the parrot.
Okay,
now
so it's
a cat.
The cat. Okay.
So now read carefully. It's going to be interesting.
What wonderful weather we have. Too much positive reinforcement.
But you've got to understand that you are talking to the cat. And his name is Behemoth.
Yeah, it's Behemoth, yeah.
Yes.
I have a friend who has a cat named like that. Exactly
yes,
the same.
After Mother and Margaret by Buhakov. My friend, I think you are a reasonable person, someone who could help Tancred with my assistance. For that, we need the function key for her Mobrium. If you were to stumble upon it and bring it back, I'd be grateful.
Yeah, so we have a side quest.
I mean, Tancred would be grateful. Now, can you switch on the codex, please? I'm wondering whether there is something written in there about this program. It's dual mask therapy. Not available.
It's not available.
Oh, what a
pity. What a shame! You will have to buy the game to know.
But I have written it. It's a wonderful text about this dual mask therapy. You would understand what this cat and parrot is doing and how to play with them. Of course, you are digging in the dirt.
Yeah, because that's what I do when I'm on the streets. Because why not? The many years of gaming have prepared me for this, so...
Yes.
Something interesting can be in trash.
Yes.
Another one.
Ah!
Take the object.
You have found something here.
Medieval battery. Okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So, kids, as you can see, just look at the trash.
I don't know if you know, but your goal here was to meet with a guy named Ezra. And yes.
Now he's here.
Ezra is dead. And here is the conversation between the doctor and the captain of Outrangers. They're having an argument.
It's very important not to only click on the characters, but also read the dialogues between some two NPCs.
Well, you know, but designers designed it this way that you can interrupt them, and then the outcome is different. If you listen to them to the end, yes, if you listen to the end, there is an outcome, and if you interrupt them, there is another outcome. It is your decision to interrupt or not.
Yeah, it's like the Twisted and Perverted, where one of the characters was arguing with another NPC, and if we just stand there, he will shot him. Yeah.
And here, because you were just listening, the captain of Outrangers was hitting the Medibot. Not a very nice move. He was very angry. Then this is him, Captain Basilides.
Yeah, and already I did something wrong.
No. The left and the right side of this bar is not bad and good. It, if you put the cursor, your cursor, over those padlocks, you will notice this is the family and this is service.
Okay.
So if you address his family values, the bar will move left side. If you address the service values, the bar will move right side. And only unlocking one of these padlocks will let you do more in this game. And you succeeded. Bravo.
I'm going to do something wrong in here.
No. It's good. I'd say that we do all we could.
I'm a very fast reader, so come on.
I need access to the body. I'd like to take a look at it. Well, you were supposed to meet with Ezra. Ezra is dead. As a game deck, you want to know why he is dead. So access to the body is a good thing.
Okay, so he agreed.
Okay.
MCC Beacon.
Yes, MCC is Mutation Control Centers. However terrible it may sound, it seems that an MCC beacon mistook him for some kind of a bat and fired at him. So you need to know that here in this lowest part of the city, there is a little threat that poisonous and venomous bats from the undercity attack people. So to prevent it, there are MCC beacons, Mutation Control Center beacons, that shoot those bats and prevent it. As you can see, Ezra has some kind of holographic bat wings, but is AI of such a beacon stupid enough to misinterpret it and to take a person that has such holographic wings and think it is a bat? Doubtful. So, but it's my opinion.
Yeah, so in game deck we shoot bats. Because how the history is funny enough. In game
Thank
deck
you.
We shoot bats.
Thank you, Matthew.
Yeah.
That's what I meant.
Let's shrink it, yeah? Okay, let it go or accuse.
Accuse him, yes.
Really? I don't want to.
Well,
we already have the access to the body, so.
But you know, he's doing something very wrong for his organization. He should know better. He should know that MCC beacons don't do such stupid things. He just admits that his beacon shot a man. He shouldn't do it. Why does he do that?
Okay.
He's a captain, you know. When you have done something wrong as an Outranger, you should cover yourself, your bodies, and so on. And he just says, okay, it's a beacon shot the boy. Here is an interesting character.
Every character is interesting in game deck.
Yes, I agree. Every has a history. Well, this one... Oh, okay.
I'm a fast reader. That's number one. Number two, we have a stream to do.
Yeah, okay. Do your work.
Yeah, I'm very impressed on how the game looks. Oh, so yes. we're the drone.
Yes.
Right now.
You are controlling the drone now.
Yay.
Yes, and look, you have access to the cameras that are attached to the lamps.
I really like the idea that you will have to walk up on something, walk very, very close to something, so you can see the icon, you can click on it. Yeah. So I know that there are games where you can just click one button and every interaction on the screen just pops out, so you can just click them all. Mm-hmm. And have everything, but in game deck you have to come to a certain place very close,
yes,
in order to trigger this interactions. So you can just go through the game and see 30%, 40% of things that we have prepared for you. And yes, after beating the game, you will talk to your friends, and not only the outcome will be different, but the playthrough of a certain case might be different too.
Of course, and what's interesting, it feels very natural. So sometimes you don't know you missed something. I could see that you missed some places where you could click an interaction icon, but you didn't. That's interesting. And it's part of the gameplay. You've got to move around. You've got to look for got to move left, right, up, down to find interesting places. They will not just be shown to lazy people.
Yeah, and it's your decision if you want to pursue a certain way or not. So you can dig everything in this game. You can click on everything, or you can just do the minimum, do a detection, and just go with it.
I will explain what you are doing now. Well, Ezra died in a place that couldn't be seen by any of these cameras. So how to play back what happened? Well, you cannot just attach to a certain camera, because none of these cameras have seen it. But you are in the future world, where there are very advanced artificial intelligence. So these cameras didn't see precisely what happened to Ezra, but they saw reflections in smooth surfaces. They saw shadows of what happened. So if you combine all the data from all the cameras about those reflections from smooth surfaces, where you could see, for example, just a part of somebody's arm holding a gun, and then on another reflection from a vehicle nearby, you could see a leg of the perpetrator, and so on. And then on another one, you could see the shadow of the victim running away or something like that. Then together, all these recordings should create the crime scene. But why? Just click on the...
On which one?
I don't know. You've got to find a way to connect all the cameras, and then you will be able to create the crime scene. You are doing very well, I must say.
Thank you very much. I'm doing my best. I'm very good at clicking at things.
You don't look like you haven't played this demo.
No, it's my first playthrough, to be honest.
Really?
I didn't want to be knowing what I'm doing.
You are doing great, I must say. Oh, you're closer.
Raziel, Marcin, I am loving your writing so on the game. The first backer build absolutely blew me away for the writing and characters. I have fallen in love with your world. It's an absolutely stunning world, or beauty and intrigue with so much depth.
Thank you. Who wrote that?
It's Razor 317 from Twitch.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very
so,
much.
So I believe he's not very that he didn't read the books. So it will be in English.
Yes,
so you can read it later.
The five parts of it, but we have translated the first two. Wow! Now,
okay. Okay, that's cool.
Yeah. So now you know what happened. You still don't. Watch carefully now.
Okay. Yeah. So not only he just fall down, he was electrocuted, I believe, and then he was shot. What a poor day to die.
I will not tell you. I don't want to spoil it for you. I liked it. It was a nice animation.
First console, okay.
It's a pity that you get the feed to Codex and we cannot read it here in this demo.
I like how smooth the game runs, even on older PCs. I really like the idea of this rain in here, and I know I said it before, but it looks really gorgeous. And Tomasz, who is doing the lighting in the game, he really brought something more to the Low City. If you compare the first screenshots from Low City with this build, it's much more beautiful and complex, and the lighting is just phenomenal.
Yes, I agree.
Okay, there's nothing to do here.
Yes, so if you look at the right part of the screen, well, here we have an interaction with Lieutenant Vera. He's a cute guy. You can talk to him and ask him what happened. He has some answers. Now he talks
So let's mm-hmm. Let's talk about why the beacons are shooting the bats, and why people are closed in the cities, and why cannot they just go for a walk outside?
Well, if you look what is going on nowadays with the nature, with humans, with our beloved species, what humans are doing to the nature, I predicted that in the 70s of the 21st century, nature will rage against humanity. It will mutate, and it will begin with insects, with mosquitoes. That I have described in Game Deck that they have started carrying a very, very dangerous virus that could cause people to die. So people escaped from villages to little towns, from little towns to big towns, and the big towns became overcrowded, and then eventually people had to fence themselves and guard themselves with antibiotic barriers from the very dangerous mutated fauna and flora, from animals and plants. So now they are living in sort of cities cages, and thus those cities are surrounded by very thick forests, jungles, but underneath you cannot separate yourself from the ground this way. So in the under cities there are several kinds of moderately dangerous species. These are rats and bats. Well, rats are quite intelligent, and they understood that it is not wise for them to climb the towers, so MCC beacons rarely shoot them. But bats are not that intelligent, and sometimes they fly too high. They are also mutated, and many animals in Game Deck Verse are venomous and toxic as well at the same time. So now you are talking to the doctor.
Yeah, and while we are talking with the doctor, I have to read what Kuba wrote. So he's in shock because he didn't know about the option with the cameras. He always tried to get to the crime scene using the MedMat, so the Medibot. Yeah, like I said, even in this small portion of the demo, you can find different branches and different ways to get to your goal. So yeah.
Yes. I wonder if you will notice when I will not tell you where. There is one very interesting interaction. I didn't see you notice it, but let's see whether you will be able to do anything with this medbot.
So I have the part for Tancred. I've got the
This
part.
function key. Oh my God,
Yeah, and
let's
here we
see.
can use the origin from Low City. We are from Low City. Our game deck is from Low City, so you can use it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. This was sarcasm, of course. The game deck who is from Low City doesn't like the concept that people from high city, from the highest higher parts of the of Warsaw City, despise people who are born here, who work here, and so on. Yeah, doctor, you have just learned that doctor is extremely sick and he will die in 3 months. So this is why he is so sarcastic. He smokes a lot and he doesn't care really. Yeah, stem cell cancer.
Yeah, and my story and Kuba's story just shows you that there are different branches in the small portion of the demo, and we are making this game, so we should know everything about it. And the people from the dev team always add something new. So whenever we have a chance to go and try the latest build, we find something new, and we find another branch, and we find another dialogues, and some dialogues change, etc. So,
Well,
yeah.
just look here. Here is the third option that is not available in demo. It is written already. It is there. I know. I have written it, but you cannot see it. There are many, many other options. So you gain the control over Medbot, and the battery is low, but you have the battery from the dirt bin. You know.
Okay, we can be disinfected. Okay. Let's check the latest scans. Two more. Okay. Let's charge the battery. So we have more options.
Yes, you did it.
Yeah,
But
let's do the control.
this, what you did here should be available when you are near the MCC beacon. Not
Okay.
here.
So
Not.
can I, yeah, so he's
It's an
following me.
exploit.
Okay. MCC beacon, you say.
Yeah, but you are near. No, you have done it. You will not do anything more over
Yeah?
there. But
Okay.
yeah, but
So
you are near the body.
I broke the
Yeah.
game.
No. Yes. What's the really? What are you doing?
I have no idea what I'm doing. I have never played this part.
Can you approach the body, please? Because
Yeah.
let's see what the medbot can do to the body. You clicked on the icon of the medbot. I think I will leave you. I mean, do what you want.
I'm just having great time. Should I install the battery, or what should I do right now? Help me, Martin, you're my only hope.
Okay, click leave.
Yeah, and on the
And
body.
click the Ezra's body. Yes. No. Examine the body.
So the face carved from plastic.
Yes. So...
Oh, we can perform surgery. Yeah, yeah, let's do it.
Yes.
And I have to say that in our professions we have the medical branch. So yeah,
you have done it previously.
No, it was already unlocked at the beginning. This is the way we want you to go in this demo. In the full version, you will have a full control on whether to go as a brute force, or as a tech genius, or a medical.
Yes, I'm very glad that show it again. That this resembles a brain and the tree at the same time. This was the idea. The symbols of this game are the two symbols: the brain and the tree of knowledge and the brain. And there is some very cool stuff about those symbols. I will not spoil it. Okay, you can go back to the game.
Thank you very much. Let's see what can we do here.
Mm-hmm. Choose wisely. Choose your words wisely.
Brain scan. Take a brain sample. Perform a bone scan. So yeah,
read all the options.
100%, his bones are broken. Because he just
Are you sure? Are you sure? Well, do it.
Okay.
Okay, do it.
As a skeleton began to appear in one of the windows, he looked normal. What?
Yes! Mindfuck, isn't it?
Are we allowed to say things like that on live stream?
I don't know. You are from marketing, not me. I'm a writer.
Yeah, you can do whatever you want.
Yes, of course. So, my friend.
Okay, so.
Food for thought.
Was it an illusion?
Well, think. You can go to the deduction tree.
I'm not very good in thinking, so. I just go and click on things.
Yes, okay.
So, okay.
You are still within an interaction, so.
I'm thinking about the disinfection mode, but before we do any of the surgeries or etc.
Do you really want to disinfect everything and remove all the traces?
What world are we living in today? We have to disinfect everything.
But
you have to disinfect the bottle. The bottle with the disinfectant.
So, okay. I will just watch. Whatever you do.
No pressure at all. No pressure at all.
No pressure.
Okay, so.
Conduct blood test, conduct brain scan, initiate disinfection mode, take a brain sample, blood test. Medibus arms are version of the vein. I heard the sound of pistons working.
The display said the blood has congealed, but it had been drawn and was being analyzed. I need to check the results when they were ready. Okay, so we have to wait for the results.
Yeah.
It's how humane thing to do in a video game. I thought that in the 22nd century we'll just get results like that.
Well, it takes time. Believe me, I'm a doctor, so.
You know how these things work.
Very bad, but turned on something akin to a floodlight, casting a faint light, and began the procedure.
Okay. Continue. The device, reported that the procedure was successful. I looked at the data. Before he died, Ezra had strongly stimulated visual interpretive fields and a distinctive bridge activity pattern. Only one state could produce this result. Devitalization. Oh, okay. This is interesting.
Yes, it is.
So let's take a brain sample. Through the nose. Okay, so it sprayed the tip with disinfectant foam. So it did it anyway, okay.
if you insert a needle into the body, you've got to disinfect the part of the body where you put the needle, because you would insert the things that were on the surface, and then the analysis would be spoiled.
Okay. Makes sense.
Yeah. And you did the very right
I did everything, order.
Order, yes. If you would take the sample of the brain first, then you wouldn't be able to make this the brain analysis.
Oh, analyze the blood test results. Mm-hmm. No signs of psychoactive substances. Significant concentration of active, okay. I have another battery, but I don't know if I want to.
You can try. Did you see that? That there was a big concentration of game pill nanobots. You know what game pill is?
Yes.
It's a drug that is used by players before playing the game.
We have the function key, so.
Oh my god. Matthew, I don't know how you do that, but you play brilliantly this game.
I'm just natural. It's just ghosts.
You have an intuition just for it. Okay, you inserted the key. Thank you, kind lady. This will surely help. I mean, Tancred will be thrilled with the world I made for her. All right, about that poor fool. He came here, flew around, but he was also in another world. Get it, realistic human. Ezra died in game.
You're true.
So, we did two things at the same time. First, this Tancred girl in this mob room, we didn't do a very good thing for her, but this cat, Behemoth, told us how Ezra died. And how is it possible? We are in reality, we are not in the game.
Ezra was killed with a weapon from a game inside the game. Ezra's brain looked as if it had been devitalized before he died. We are playing a game. Game pill nanobots, so... Yeah, I believe this hypothesis, because the science don't lie.
Okay.
Can I do it?
You've got to press longer than most.
So, how did Ezra die?
How is it possible? But you've got to answer all the other...
Ezra was killed with a weapon from a game, or he died inside the game. So I have to just answer every single one of these?
I don't know now. I don't think so.
Because this hypothesis is valid, the beacon shot him on the walkway, so but they used the beacon, so it's nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
Gunshot. Mm-hmm. We saw an image of someone shooting him, but...
You've got to gather more information to unlock another path. Because you saw he was shot, but he was shot after he fell.
Yeah, so accident.
Yeah.
He got hive and crashed, overdose. The fall was the cause of death. Hypothesis makes no sense. Yeah, let's
check
go
the
with
clues.
This
check
one.
The clues on the left. Oh, okay.
Which one? There's no sign of fall damage, so...
Yeah.
The bones are intact.
Yeah.
So... Not on my watch. Yeah, but I have no idea if the gunshot was real or not, because we saw someone.
But you know, he may have fallen and died. And then I'm talking too much. I'm saying too much.
No, I'm just thinking about if... Because we don't have the information if his brain is out. So if he was shot, he would have a damaged head. And I don't have the information.
Well, I think you didn't examine the body thoroughly. The wound is, in fact, in his chest, not in his head. It looked like...
inspect the head. Stiff tongue, dry saliva. Okay. No personal items, not even a walktail. Inspect the chest. Oh, we have some options available. Under clothes or feel his chest. Let's check under clothes. Small gunshot exit wound. So he was shot. It sounded hollow inside. The sound near the wound should have been flat due to extravasation. You're using wise words.
Medical words, but you know, when there is a wound, there should be a lot of blood around it. If there isn't, then there is something wrong with this wound.
Yeah, but isn't this blood, the red in here?
Sort of, yes. Well, concentrate.
Yeah,
Don't.
it looked like he had been struck by lightning. Like I said, he fell down, there was an electrical sound, and then someone shot him, yeah?
But read it. It looked like he had been struck by lightning, but the marks were off. I
Okay.
rubbed my eyes and took another look at Ezra's arm. Nothing. I was confused. And now,
Jesus,
be
Martin.
careful, be careful, be careful now. It's an important point here.
Flashing
You saw a
images behind it.
flash.
Yeah, look at the
Yes.
flash.
It lasted a
Semi-transparent
fraction of a second. A
sign.
semi-transparent sign popped out up right above Ezra's head from the pavement. Onai Man, level 14, hit points 0. The
Okay.
mirage vanished.
There's a bloody hole in his coat and his back too, it seemed. So he was shot.
Yeah.
So let's take a look at the bullet. So yeah, it was a hologram.
Yes, and here's an important thing. To create such an illusion, you need to wear a device. It's called Ilgen. So where is Ilgen? And this Lieutenant Vera says, "Take a guess, ma'am. That's why I keep fiddling with him. I can't find the Ilgen that generates the wings. Did he swallow it?"
Yeah, but I have no other options here.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, but we have some new things in the codex not available in the demo. Oh, we have someone. Something. Municipal heuristic systems.
But
From the dark web.
it should have been fired in another place. I don't know why it's fired here.
Yeah, nothing in here.
Pity.
So he was shot.
Yes, but I wonder.
The shot was fired after Ezra's death.
Oh,
Yeah,
I see.
because there's not enough blood. So if someone
Yeah.
is already dead and you shot him, there's no blood circulation. Am I right?
Yes,
I've seen
I'm.
enough TV shows about murders.
How do you do that? I all the time I have the impression that you are not paying enough attention to what is going on in
Well,
this game, but you
it's
do. But
natural.
how do you do it? How do you do
I'm
it?
just a good player, and I know
You
how to,
are.
yeah.
You are much better than me. I would have to concentrate a lot and think a lot, but and you do everything just. Yes, you are natural.
So it's murder, or was killed with a weapon from game. So we have to fight another one. The beaten didn't shoot Ezra. Shot was fired after Ezra's death.
I must say, this deduction system is good.
The whole game is good. If the whole game is as good as this portion of this game,
It is better. It is better.
I'm taking 2 weeks off when the game premieres, and I will just playing. Yeah, but Kuba won't let me.
It is better, and you haven't seen half of it. Really, the some cool things happening, animations and so on, and you didn't see them yet.
Yeah, but I have to have everything in order to make the deduction, because I don't know what's here.
What's here?
Yeah, we have to talk with the... Where is he?
Can you see the right side of the screen? Find compromising materials about the captain or provoke him into a fight.
Yeah, let's fight.
I knew that. I've got to find him first.
Yeah, I think he's here, yeah.
It's the captain, yes.
He's
a drone operator.
Interject. Not to interrupt. Let's wait. Yeah, let's interrupt. He's talking something not related to the case.
Yes. Well, without Codex, you will not know who he is. His name is Rama Matan. He's corporal. He is from a very, very rich Australian family. And he doesn't want to be here. He's an outranger because his father told him to do so, because he was a very, very bad boy in his family. He did bad things, so he's cast here, and he doesn't like it, really.
Okay, how old are you? I don't like this question. Let's talk about his death. Oh, sorry, Pablo. I love this guy. Okay. Yeah, let's inquire. Fucking star! Rising star. Okay. So, this guy is a celebrity.
Yes, this guy who died was a rising star in a Gudabets game. This game is special because the players, well, it's an esport game, the players actually feel pain. When you get wounds, you just not get the hit points distracted from a pool, but you feel pain. And the more wounds you get, the bigger pain you feel. So these players are like gladiators, and Ezra Onai was very good at it, so he was loved.
Yeah, so yeah, it's the same boss, so yeah. Provoke him to fight. Yeah, I have no idea where to find some materials. I believe that this guy might have the materials, but I don't know how to talk to him. So yeah, I will have to
fight.
Do
you want some advice?
Yeah, yeah.
Try to talk to the captain again, please.
With this one or with this one?
Yes, this one. Good, Vasily, this is.
Yeah, and I just have an option to provoke you.
Yeah.
Okay, but we can insult the leadership. Or his people.
You are on the family side. You are on the family side. Remember those padlocks?
Yeah, so, but I have no idea which of these is the family side.
People or leadership?
Yeah, service let's go with on people. The right? Yeah, I did it wrong. I did it the other way. Oh no, I did
yes,
it wrong.
Yes,
yeah?
Yeah.
I have no idea how I did it. I'm a natural.
It's simple. The left padlock is family. The right padlock is service. So if you... but it wasn't enough to provoke him, I'm afraid.
Yeah, and do I have an option to do something more, or?
Well, I can go to the doctor and talk about Captain.
Nothing to do here.
Ah, nothing yet. So, you're doing it too fast.
Yeah, because I'm just clicking the things in here. If he has anything on the captain. Yes. Okay. Okay. Make reference to connections. Of course, I mean, I'd film the ugly guy beating up a medibot. The question is, though, why should I give it to you? Okay.
Well, you would have to know the history of this movie director, and this history is written in the codex, and the codex is not available in the demo. So I can tell you that this movie director hates AI and likes medibots.
So it's easy one.
Yeah.
Okay, and we have. Yes,
you have now the compromising materials about the captain, so you have to go back to Pax, yes, to the doctor.
Okay, ask for the explanation.
Mm-hmm.
No substances and vitalization, it's a typical scan of someone lying on a couch while in game. Okay! I hate this game so much because all of these options are valid, and you always have to think about what you're doing.
Yes.
Whether we'll be
surprisingly, you did very well.
Yeah. So let's just doubt it. Okay, game in mix. New clue!
Why so fast? Okay.
Yeah, but it was from the...
Yes.
It was from here,
so,
this one, so...
Decision.
How did he die? I still haven't got this one. Yeah, but can we go to the captain and say that we have materials to...
Oh, you give me a check.
Nope. Okay, so let's do it. I'm just gonna pick the one options. I believe it's valid.
Can I show you something?
Of course.
I'm interested.
Yeah.
I'm interested in one thing. Can you please go north now?
Okay.
North. Yeah. Here. Yeah.
Yeah, something here. Sidewalk graffiti. Take a closer look. The end of iteration is near.
That's it?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's not available in demo. Oh, really? Because it is, you know what it is? It is the place that you can access the very interesting system. And thanks to the system, you are able to hack some things.
Not in the demo.
Pity, really. But what about this beacon here, this MCC beacon that hangs here?
Not available in the demo.
What you need now is... decide how he died, I think.
Yeah, I tried to do it, but you just wanted to try something.
But I think that in this demo you will not have all the information.
It wasn't an accident. It was a murder, and the MCC beacon was only a smoke screen, but I don't know how exactly he died.
Maybe the viewers will decide, or you can decide.
I think it was a murder because he was killed and then shot. But well, if someone shot you, it's a murder.
Yes, of course.
But
is it a murder?
I have no idea how he died.
Is it a murder when you are already dead and somebody shoots you?
Well, it's an intent, so.
And remember these images that appeared above Ezra's head?
Can I just go with I don't know and then we will have another...
Well, you are the player.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay. So you moved with your deduction, but there are no data over here.
He looks like a corporate CEO.
Really? You have that impression?
Yeah, with the suit, etc.
Interesting, very interesting.
Senior specialist. Insurer, okay. Psychoscan.
Yeah.
Yeah, the chat goes with the that he was killed in game. Okay, what do we have?
Your goal here was really to get the psycho scan. There were three ways. Okay.
Yeah, let's sign it.
I don't.
Did I do something wrong?
No, everything's fine.
Because sometimes I'm just looking at your expression and I'm like, oh no, I did something wrong. Oh no, there was a better way to do it.
It's just, there were just three more ways to get this psycho scan. So this is our game. So there are so many ways to achieve a goal that, well, you have it. So this psycho scan, what you will do with it is not available in this demo. When you get home, get to the apartment, wait a second. There is an interesting thing going to happen here. When you go to the apartment, you can talk to Ezra, who died here, because you got the psycho scan, but the psycho scan is taken from a dead brain. So this V-ghost of Ezra will not be as good as when the psycho scan was taken from a living brain. So this is how you will probably know why Ezra died. Talking to the ghost of him, to the V-ghost of him. So, you may play on.
Okay. Oh my god, no!
Yeah.
Why? I'm the good guy. Where's Nabo? Okay, see? So someone is fiddling with my brain.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is the part of the demo not available on Steam and GOG. It's just for the guys who backed the game on Kickstarter. So if you just played the game on Steam or GOG, so the free demo, you can see what's next.
Yeah.
Is it me or did that guy in the suit looks like Martin? The chat says.
There was questions like that. I don't know. I like very much our artist who did that silhouette. So maybe he liked me as well and did it for me. I have no idea. I have to ask him.
We have a question from Piotr. This looks good, but will it be in Polish? Yes, we will translate the game, the full game, before the release, so you can play in Polish. In fact, the game is written in Polish, and then it will be translated to other languages.
Yes, the game is written in Polish, then it is translated into English, so rest assured there will be a nice Polish version.
Okay, Ramona.
So now your aim, your goal is to find the person who shot you. So this quitter says he didn't look, he didn't see anybody.
Okay.
And now you got to know that two groups of people in the bar, there are trolls and there are sleeves. There are two competing groups of people, so you will have to decide whom to like.
There's so many options in here.
Yeah, you are in the bar. You walk into the bar, what do you do?
Go to the bartender.
So you access the bar system?
Yeah, check the alcohol. This is the first thing we do. Beer, whiskey and vodka. Polish and Russian. Let's take the Polish vodka.
So there are some sleeves, some people here in the bar that liked that you have chosen vodka.
Okay. That's a lot of vodka wasted right here. I just said this shit. Okay. No more alcohol for me. Yeah, nothing to do here. New data. Psycho scan. Not available in the demo.
You enter the codex. Yeah. So,
so. You wanted to say something?
Yes, in the codex there is an explanation who trolls are and who sleeves are and how to treat them. Well, the trolls are sober and like games. The sleeves...
So it's not available here.
No.
So I don't know if you can say something more about the codex, not to spoil anyone's fun.
I don't know either. I'm just saying that if there was codex available, you would surely know how to treat trolls and how to treat sleeves. Well, the name sleeves is from the fact that in this world the sleeves of your clothes adapt to your size. And if you are poor, if you live in low city, then sometimes your clothes are of bad produced badly, and the sleeves are too long, so these people just try to fix those sleeves with metal, with plastic, with leather, and this is why they are called like that, sleeves. What are you doing, Matt?
What am I doing? I'm just uploading the posters of Ezra. Because I'm the good guy.
Alright.
So let's... Yeah.
So, this way you move toward trolls. I don't know if you can see, but
yeah, yeah,
this...
Yeah. On the right.
Yeah. Yeah. No, so no. This... you are... Trolls like it, so... This bar should be moving in the other direction, I think.
Why?
I think it's a bug. The left, the yellow side should be bigger because trolls like when you tinker with posters. You don't like dancing?
I did already dance, so...
Really?
Yeah. Head of marketing. Okay. Nothing to see here. Kill them all. He was in the Twisted and Perverted demo as well.
Yes. It's the old man.
And the Trepanator. So yeah, so he's a Zoinet. We had an article on Steam about Zoinet, so
yes.
If you're interested, just go there and read about it. Yeah, so it looks like we're going with the sleeves. The sleeves are red, yeah?
Yes. Yes. I was wrong. It's all right. There is no bug here. You were uploading the portrait of Ezra and sleeves like Ezra. Yes. It's all right. Trolls would like you if you would spoil the posters.
So if you have played the first demo and this one, you might connect some dots. I already did right here, but I don't want to talk about it so you can figure it out yourself. Mm-hmm. So I don't want to spoil too much. Yeah, so it looks like we can talk a lot. Change tables.
Yes, now you don't know the bar too well, and you cannot decide whom to prank, and you didn't wake kill them all yet.
The situation. Yeah, so again, in two or three short sentences, who is old yet?
Yes, old yet is a bartender. He's the owner of this club, which his name is Yet Is Coming. He was a soldier. He was a mercenary. You can see that looking at his bionic hand. Well, in Game Deck Verse, it isn't a common thing that people have bionic limbs because it is possible to just regenerate your limbs. You can use stem cells and just regenerate them, or you can print a new limb. So if every person on Earth can just regenerate his limbs or her limbs, why old yet is having a bionic hand? Well, it's a custom of mercenaries. They, if they are wounded, if they lose a limb, they is their sign that they do not regenerate it. They have this bionic hand. There is a subtle connection between this bartender and some other characters here, but I don't want to spoil it.
So yeah, I did go with the right path because, as I can see, Old Yet is also supporting the sleeve, so...
Yes.
I think he's my favorite NPC. He looks badass.
Yes, it is one of the first the artists have created. Oops. Okay, this guy is funny.
Yeah, and both of these options are great. Can't snatch my brain. Yeah, I did the right thing to do. Yeah. This game brings me so much joy and happiness when I pick the right option.
I don't know how you do that, really, Matthew.
I have to swear on my mother that I have never played this demo before. I have never been in this bar before. This is the first time I'm playing the game from the beginning to the end.
Either you are brilliant or our designers are brilliant that they allow.
Why not both?
Why not both? Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Well, regular Joe is really an interesting NPC.
Blue anti-corporate.
Well, that's quick. Too quick.
Why too quick? Yeah, I've never been to this bar before. Yeah, you sound like a typical 18-year-old kid.
Ah, so you have downloaded his profile. No anti-corporate.
Okay, this is new.
Yeah. Pedra Fides.
You look like a troll.
Yeah, but she's not a typical troll.
HR lady.
Well, she's a troll. But she's a corporal woman. She works in human resources. And she knows psychology very well. And she likes to experiment with people, so we got to be careful.
Addicted to plexus and virtualia is the kind of disorder we are about to start normalizing, like we did with obesity. Funny thing, I should have not said that word because apparently, some streaming platforms are saying that it's not okay anymore to say. So, beware and not say this word again.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, I think I didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah.
Arguments. Yeah, let's do it.
I like it.
Okay. Yeah, it's windy in here.
Yeah. I like the work of our sound guy here. Can you hear it? What's happening? Great. Their voices. And there is Rick.
Let's observe. This is the best defense. Okay, so I believe that Cam is the leader of trolls.
You may check it.
Hello, Slick.
He's a great card player.
So you're saying that it's not a very wise thing to do.
What?
Well, let's challenge my luck.
Oh my god, you're playing. Oh my god.
No pressure at all, Martin. No. Hmm. Okay, it sounds like the guy who just tries to sell you a calendar through doors.
Yes, he really tries to sell you something.
He sounds like Umbra from Twisted and Perverted.
Yeah, exactly, precisely, and he's from the same organization. So you get to know better and better the bar, the sleeves, the trolls, and the guys from an organization from the game Knight's Code.
Yeah, the Horn clan.
Yes, the clan Horn. Yes.
Should I join the clan?
I don't know. It's your call.
I will get some answers if I join the clan.
Maybe.
Let's just talk about Ezra. Well, Ezra was trying to find the answers, and he's dead. So, joining a clan is not something you want to do if you want to live. So let's do it.
What can go wrong?
Yeah, I'm a game deck. So.
Yes.
You want access to all of my data? Okay. Yeah, sure, why not? They run upstairs. Okay. So I know where to go. Ah, I did it again. So we are closer to the left side.
Mm-hmm.
What the music? This isn't music, it's some junky noise. Okay, but did we won with Slick? What happened here? I'm not a troll. Yeah, I cannot do anything with.
Yeah.
I have to exchange the battery in my headphones. So I will do it very quick. Yeah, it's right. One of the advantages of having a wireless headphones, but it's so convenient. So let me just go.
Okay.
Here.
Okay.
And it just takes like 10 seconds to do. So yeah, okay. I'm back. This is the end of the show, guys. End of the show. Okay, so I will have to take this troll out. So maybe change the music. Music disrupts thinking, something calming, things that stimulate imagination. Yeah, let's go with this. Okay. Let's request a song for the troll so we can play with this guy. Look at me, I am smart. A problem and a solution. Let's ask about the hooded person. What is the main plot of the game?
I've got to tell you something now. This guy, Slick, there is an information about him in the codex. He has a lying issue. Sometimes he tells the truth, sometimes he lies. If you know how to talk to him, you will know whether he's saying the truth or not. But without codex, it's impossible to know that. So now it's the time for your intuition.
I know I already picked the wrong answer, I believe. But, question from the chat. Someone played the GOG demo, someone saw the backers demo. And he got the idea that I'm a game dev and you're solving crimes and investigate and so on. But what is the main plot? What is the game about? So we cannot tell you what is the game is about because the first chapters are not available yet. So
yes, but generally speaking, without spoiling anything, the game is about the life of a game dev. And the game is divided into chapters that are sort of separate commissions, jobs for the game deck. So he's a private eye, private detective, private investigator who solves mysteries that always are connected with virtual realities, with sensory worlds. Of course, there is a meta plot, a bigger story behind it. There is a bigger mystery, but of course I cannot tell you what it is. This part is the middle of the game. We are deep in the game and we wanted to meet with Ezra because he knew something very important that was connected with this meta plot. Alas, he is dead. We want to find out why he is dead. To know that, we have to talk to his psycho scan. We can do this in the apartment. In the meantime, we got shot. We want to know why we got shot. This is why we are in this bar. So without spoiling too much, I can tell you this. Well, that's all. Matthew, what was that enough? Was I communicative?
Well, it wasn't my question, so we'll have to wait and see.
So I can see that you have all the pink bar now.
Yeah, so the sleeves are now talking with me.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so it's more than enough. So yeah.
Okay.
Another copy sold.
Tell your friends.
Not is me boss. Get info from Slick. And Slick? We did it. Get info from Kill Them All.
Yes, you got this info.
Yeah. So, hello. In order to talk to him, he's wake
sleeping.
Him up. Okay. Okay.
So you decided to prank regular Joe.
Yeah, but I want to wake this guy up.
I would help you if you wouldn't be so quick with these interactions.
So I blew it, so I can't go.
I don't remember now. I think there are many ways to wake him up. Now, what I know is that this hologram is at regular Joe's now.
Hey, Joe. Yeah, we can get a pass, but not so soon. Yeah, we've done so already. I have another poster here. So, yeah. Okay, so you have to go. Cannot wait to play it. Hopefully, it won't be postponed again. We're making everything we can to get the game ready till September, and everything just shows us that this will be the date. So it's on the trailer already, so we have nothing more to to say. But we are having our time, and it would be great From the shape of this demo, I can see that the branching is already already visible for someone who just wants to play the game.
Yes, it is. It is. It is. There's still many really interesting things that can happen in the bar, but we just couldn't see them. They concerned the system of the bar. They concerned the brain fix, this machine that is at the back of the bar near the toilets. We can use this machine, of course, and we can even spoil them. Yes, here is the system of the bar, and it's rather a complex task to use it. But
oh, let's do it. What can go wrong?
Okay. You remember you talked to one guy and you got his profile.
Yeah.
I wonder if you have the information about this guy in Codex. In the full game, you should have, and it should help you in creating the feed, but create something of a hypnosis for this guy so that he would tell you what you want him to tell you.
Yeah, so I'm doing it great.
How do you do that?
So concerned about.
Really, I don't know.
It's further the news. Anti-corporate stream. Well.
Oh, that's the first step.
Yeah, but it did reset, so let's do the audio. CEO's accused of fraud. No!
I see, it's not that easy. It is not that easy, I told you. You've got to... first, you've got to know a profile of a person and do... very precise steps to influence that person. Now we are just guessing, and it will not work that very easy. Or maybe you are a good gambler and the luck will favor you.
I have no idea where to go.
Well, one more step and they will be victorious. If you do that, you will be, I will call you a genius of intuition.
I have no idea what to do.
You are a genius. You are a genius. But now you've got to find, yes. You've
so
got to
one?
Find this, you've got to find the guy.
Well. Yeah, I believe I know which one was it, so. Yeah, it's this one.
No, it's the one that hired you to Clan Hon.
Yeah, but I just picked the Nahum. So it should be this
really?
One. Yeah.
Oh. Maybe I did something wrong.
Yeah, we also have this one.
Yeah.
So what happened here?
I don't know. Maybe we'll try to fix the robot, the bartender. I wonder if it's possible now. It's possible to fix him.
Not available. End the demo. Yeah, so
not
let's
available?
Talk about old yet. Yeah, it's not available.
Pity. It's a very fine animation there.
Yeah, that's giving me a beer.
Ah, he poured some beer to you.
I knew it's going to happen, but hey. So it looks like I have nothing more to do.
It's a pity you cannot wake him up. Oh my god, yeah, but I like to talk to him.
Yeah, but did I do something wrong or it's just not available?
I think it is available, but you are too quick for my brain and I couldn't just follow the steps. So I really don't know what.
Yeah, so I was designing the experience for Nahum. For this one.
Ah, yes.
And this is the guy who recruited me to the Hon clan.
Yes.
So.
Right, yes, I remember.
It should be. Available.
There should be an effect, yes. Yes.
So I have no idea what's the name of the other guys. Let's do corporate stream. Okay. So now I know which path to choose.
Okay.
Okay. So let's do it again. Gamepeel Market embezzlement. Nope. 10 best couches of the year.
Believe me.
What?
Believe me.
I'm losing you.
Yes. Okay, you should know what you are doing. Without it, you will not be able to. Yeah, okay. Will you check the deduction?
Yeah.
I wonder what there is. Leave this place.
No, I have to do it. This is what I want to do. Oh no. Oh yeah, I have to go this way.
Oh, it is a good thing to know what Arlak is which. Matthew, stop tinkering.
Why?
Because. Okay.
Yeah, it's a failure. Okay, so yeah, let's go with it. I didn't like this anymore. I was thinking that when I go left, it will be the good solution. So yeah. I did the wrong thing with the home, because I thought I was designing for this guy. And I have no idea how this guy is called. Talk to Gulu. Charge the entrance free to the bar. I did it already. So it should be ticked. Well, this guy is not very talkative. Let's talk with Cam.
There is one situation when you can talk to him about a brilliant topic. Mm-hmm. I love it, but you have to do before that a certain thing that you didn't do, so this conversation is just not available. But if you do that, it's one of my most favorite conversations in the game with this guy. Here is Cam Grozny, she is competing with Tik as far as the leadership of the trolls is concerned.
Okay. And this is a brain fix. So, what is a brain fix?
Well, it's a machine that sells neuro drinks or plexes. If you want to get high without...
Okay, that's enough. I will go there.
Okay.
I cannot.
Why? Why can't you use brain fix?
I have no idea.
Well, it's... Well, you have to do something before it, I presume.
Let's see if we can do some deductions.
Mm-hmm.
But the motive to kill Ezra. Ezra made throwing difficult for Tik, and throwing was the lunatic's whole life. It wasn't a suicide, it wasn't an accident, so it's either Ramona or Herman.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this one is after the Twisted and Perverted mission, right?
Yes. Twisted and Perverted, first mission.
So, I think that Herman had the motive, because in Twisted and Perverted, in the first demo...
Don't say too much.
In the first demo, I believe that there was something about trolls.
Yes.
And there was a Herman in there. So...
Yes.
Let's try to go this way. Who shot me? Ramona, Tik, one of the sleeves, one of the trolls. It sounds like a troll. What is Ezra up to? Was taking revenge on the trolls, he was spying on the Horn Clan. Hello, Mr. Frostchick. He joined the Horn Clan, or he returned to Low City. So, was he a spy or was he a member?
This whole thing may sound like a little bit mysterious to people who just entered this demo and don't know previous adventures, but this Ezra guy is someone whom we know from almost the very beginning of the game, so these questions and answers are deeper for a player who played the game from the beginning. Okay. Who is the killer?
Tik had a reason to kill Ezra. A troll shot at me. Ezra wanted to take revenge on the trolls when he was collecting intel on the Horn Clan. It wasn't an accident. It wasn't a suicide. It might have been Tik.
It might.
Do we have one option unavailable yet? So... Let's talk with Yet. Hello, Mr. Yet. Let's talk about Rick. What's about the unit? Crystal dust. Okay. I believe that Yet is a person who doesn't like Ritualias.
Mm-hmm.
So let's agree. I thought someone was observing me. I looked around, nothing. Get a pass. Get rid of calm. Okay. Let's agree. Without asking why. Hello. so direct. I thought that it would be some elaborative piece about some psychological evaluation and
a
Tarantino style dialogue, so we can just convince.
I don't want to offend you and so on. Yes, we'll
convince her to go outside because the weather is great and something like this. And this is like, old Jed doesn't like you, so get out.
Yeah, direct.
Okay. If you destroy the brain fix. Okay. It's dangerous and addictive. These plexus are dumb. Okay.
Make people dumb.
Make the people, okay. So it's like a drug, yeah? For your brain.
It is, but not necessarily she's telling the truth. You know, she's selling the drugs. BrainFix sells plexus that are neuro drinks, yes? So is it a wise thing to believe a person who sells drug that something is unhealthy? It is for you to decide.
Oh, there's something new. How do you enhance your psychedelic trip? Okay.
Yeah, and you get it to the codex, how to make it feel better, but yeah.
Yeah,
there's nothing here. So now you can, you can use now it.
And we can destroy it, so we will do a
but
favor.
But you can use it also. Okay, your choice.
We either help Cam and go upstairs, or we help Old Yet and go upstairs. So let's use it.
So now you have a plex downloaded to your brain. You are high. Look at the sound of this bar. It indicates that you are in the very different state of consciousness. And now talk to Blue, please.
Okay, so let's talk with Blue.
I gaze into his. Oh, it's in Polish.
Yeah, this one is in Polish. So apparently, BrainFix, what it does, it teaches you Polish.
Yes, let's share the name, occupation, roles. Let's reach for the cell. It's amorphous and with no traits. If you were a dog and a completely different person, that would remain the same, which means it always has a common source. We are all one.
So he looked like a very dumb NPC, but it turns out that he was just high.
Yes.
Okay.
This man was different, smarter. Oh, okay.
Let's continue to look. Oh, one really? It's so psychological.
I love it.
Let's leave him here. So, given the plex influence. Okay, so we're not getting rid of Cam. Maybe we can talk with
not
yet.
Mm-hmm. Give into optimism. Ah.
Yeah, we'll go there. Again, two options. I won't tell him to reconcile because he would just smash me with his robotic arm. Mm-hmm. Peace and love. Oh Jesus. So, everyone will have another options right now.
I think you can go upstairs now.
Yeah, but there's so many options right now.
Yeah.
I want after, to see what
after
what happened.
You got high.
Hug the trolls, of course. God damn it, really? Yeah, peace and love. Peace and love. Hello, Mr. DJ. Would you like a hug? No.
He's just working here.
So maybe dance? Yeah.
Yes.
It's the same dance before.
If you play with male character, the dance is different. So you want to hug everybody?
Yeah, everyone. Spike his beer with a stimulant, yeah. Yeah, so he's awake.
How do you do that?
Because I'm a genius!
You are a genius!
Of course I am! Okay.
So, he mentioned Harvest Time. Harvest Time is a game that we visit previous to this case. So, if we know something about the Harvest Time, this conversation would be even deeper.
Okay, so he's talking about Ramona. Mm-hmm. Well, didn't work out the way I wanted.
Well,
I think it's everything we can do right now, so we have to do a deduction, I believe.
There's so many more things, but most of them are locked in the demo.
I can destroy it.
Yes, yes, do that.
Really?
I don't know. It's your game.
No, it made me look good, and I mm-hmm. feel good. I cannot break in.
Really? Oh. So, talk to... do the deduction. You can say tick, yes?
I can do a deduction.
Yeah, so... Point to tick.
Yeah, but if that's not tick... Yeah, let's go with it.
Okay, now you may mention tick.
Can we go upstairs?
I hope yeah. so, yeah.
Okay. Well, what happens? Okay. The user of the outermost couch was convulsing. Okay. I had to keep her distracted until the Outrangers arrived. So we're stalling. Okay. So do I have to make her fear or feel anger?
If there was codex available in this demo, you would know how to talk to her. You would know what she likes and what doesn't like. Now it's only an intuition thing.
Let's talk about her grandfather.
Mm-hmm.
But if I have to stall, I will have to pick one option from this side and one option from this side, so she will
point at the padlocks.
Yeah, this one is fear and this one is anger.
Right.
But do I have to unlock anything in order to succeed? Yes. Or can I just pick one of this one and this one? So it will be in the middle and we will have a lot of time to talk.
I won't tell you.
Thank you, Martin. Very, very helpful.
Can you see the bar on the right side? Talk with Ramona until Outrangers arrive.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay.
Yeah. What? Okay. I don't like the sound of it. Okay, so let's go to the left.
Okay. We are closer.
Come on! I did great all the time, and the last dialogue I have, I would be just...
There are no fail states in game the game.
Yeah, it was unused, so... Yeah, there's no option in here. So should I help Ramona or not?
It's your call.
Well, she shot me. She doesn't like the way I talk. She's angry. Of course I will agree. I think there was something more about it, and I think that Ramona is a very important piece of a puzzle here, so...
Yes.
I believe that making friends in game deck is more important than making enemies.
Well, it depends. Sometimes you have to choose.
This one is... Right. No data. Yeah, if you have the glacier.
I like the sounds of this game.
Yeah. I just have to say I don't believe there's something more we can do. Oh yeah, there's one in here. Okay, I think it's that's it. Yeah. That's the end of the demo. And yes. We are perfectly 2 hours.
Yes.
From the start. So
incredible.
Yeah, this was intense. Yeah, I was so thrilled about this demo, and as I said, I think that I've made the right call to not playing the game before. So yes, as I said, that was my first playthrough of this demo, and I had a lot of fun playing this game, because you feel the kind of uncertainty while playing this game, because many options looks viable, and many options look like this is the right option to yes, this is the right dialogue branch to go, and you will think that it's always the good way to go, and mm-hmm, like 2 or 3 hours into the game, you will find out that you've been played, or the guy who told you that he's a good guy will be a bad guy, etc. So I love the idea of the Iron Detective mode, which was unlocked mm-hmm during the Kickstarter, mm-hmm, where you cannot load a save.
Yes.
And I will be playing this mode because I like it very much. So I will have to live with the decisions I've made, like in the real life. And yes, I think that everyone should play Game Deck this way, because you cannot go back and make it go make the game go better for you. So
you've got to live with the consequences of your decisions. Well, the motto of this game, the punch, not the punchline, but the main sentence of this game is: you are the sum of your choices. You are the trail that you leave behind you. This is your story.
Yes.
So you cannot load a save in real life, and this is the kind of experience we are trying to propose here in this game. I liked your play as well, because I knew what you don't see, and I knew that many players playing the same will go different paths and will see other stuff, other cool stuff, really. And I can't wait. Well, the dream of Marcin Rybiński, the lead designer of this game, is that players would meet and would tell stories that they experienced playing this game, and they would tell different stories. And I can see now that his dream may come true. Me playing this game and you playing this game would create two different stories. They would have some points similar, but they would really be different.
Yeah, I like to call it a fluid narrative. So mm-hmm, the game adapts to your choices, and mm-hmm, you never know if you've made the right decision.
Yes, it's incredible that it is smooth. You cannot even see that you had other options. It's very interesting.
Yeah, and what I like about Game Deck is that if you fail, well, there is no fail state in this game. No. But when you're picking a decision which doesn't unlock the objective, you can still mm-hmm go on with the case. So
yes,
no blockage.
There is no fail state. There are only consequences of your choices.
Yeah, like in real life, I like to say that Game Deck is like a marriage. If you say your wife, but you didn't like the soup, there's no going back. You cannot load the save. You just have to live with it. So,
and the game will not be over. There will be just consequences.
Yes, and remember that you are the sum of your choices. So if you decided to marry this girl, you shouldn't say things like, "I didn't like the soup."
Yes. Yeah.
So play Game Deck responsibly.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much, Marcin. I had a thank blast, and it was always a pleasure.
My dog was watching you playing, so my dog will say goodbye. Oh, my dog is very sleepy. So, Mikey, look here, Mikey. No.
We have a question about the ending. So does endings reflect this fluid narrative? Will there be logic multiple endings based on your decisions throughout the game, or just an important moments?
The ending is designed this way that you will meet the consequences of your choices. We paid big attention to that, that player will feel the consequences at the ending. It's the goal of the whole game, so we couldn't miss it. We wanted the player to know that his decisions had the payoff. So yes, the ending will reflect the whole gameplay, I would say.
Okay, I had a great time, as always, with you, Marcin. I don't know if you noticed this, but we have some weird connection when
yes,
we are on the same same material.
Yeah, I liked it too.
I look forward to do more live streams with you, maybe when the game comes out. Yeah, because
definitely. I like your style.
Because I like the game, but I like talking to you more. So combining the gameplay with our talks is just a wonderful way to spend some free time.
Agree.
So even if we do this after hours, after our working hours,
sure.
I don't consider this as a work time. Just having fun with my friends. So
I had fun too. Watching you play, how you do this? I will have to analyze it later.
I just have a good intuition. That's all.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you.
It was a great live stream. I believe it will be available as a recording afterwards. So once again, thank you, Marcin, for being with me here today.
Thank you.
And my name is Mateusz, and I would like to see you again sometimes. And if you want to follow our game development, be sure to add Game Deck to Steam wishlist or GOG wishlist, because we are on both of the sites. We are also on the Epic Game Store. This is something new. Not everyone know about it. We have a Twitter account, our private Discord channel, so you can join it. We have also a Facebook channel, so be sure to follow if you want to be up to date with our announcements. Have a great day. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.